Well, one quarterback competition resolved. Another one still pending in Pittsburgh.
Whoa.
Russell Wilson gets his first start in the preseason, first action, first time we've seen him in uniform and actually playing. He handled four drives on Saturday night against the Bills. Justin Fields came in and handled four drives. And right now, as Mike Tomlin said himself, and we'll hear from him in a second, but basically the pass protection was so bad for both quarterbacks, it really is kind of an incomplete so far. But I will say this, eyeball test. What does Russell Wilson look like? And I think we're all looking at him in this new uniform and asking ourselves, does he look like the guy that used to wear the Seahawks uniform, or does he look like the guy that used to wear the Broncos uniform? And based on what I saw Saturday night, he looked a lot more like the guy who played for the Broncos, not the guy who played for the Seahawks.
Yeah, I don't disagree with you there. I don't. You know, I think the first thing is, you alluded to it, the pass protection. Their first rounder from two drafts ago, Broderick Jones. I mean, these are all him getting whooped by everybody, really, for
Gregory
the most
Rousseau.
Part.
Gregory Rousseau ate his lunch.
He did. He ate his lunch. There's no doubt about that. So it was hard. I didn't watch, like, I watched the film of this yesterday. I didn't come away with it going, oh man, Russell Wilson missed people wide open and there was nothing there to be had and what the hell is he looking at and all of that, right? So, yeah, there wasn't like
– never got to that point.
He never got to that point.
The plays were falling apart.
They were.
But remember what he used to be.
Exactly.
What he used to be was a guy who could run away from that.
I'm with you.
Sorry.
I'm going – yeah, it's okay. We think alike. That's where I was going with it, right? Justin Fields had the same issues. He found ways to make it happen, right? He made – at least got the ball moving, got some – create. You know, ran a little bit, did all of that. So, yeah, I mean, again, it didn't blow you away. And I know Pittsburgh's trying to keep it simple. But as it stands here right now and looks, and again, I don't want to overjudge it. It's still Russell Wilson's first game here as a Steeler and all that. But I'm a little bit more like a play Justin Fields. I just think Justin Fields is going to lay it on the line to win the football game. Yeah, he's not perfect throwing the ball, but he's good enough that way. And then his playmaking ability with his legs, his ability to run on game plan design quarterback runs, I just think fits Pittsburgh and what they want to do anyways. Oh, we'll take a shot. We'll run the ball. Oh, you know, we'll fake a speed sweep. Oh, no, Justin Fields is going the other way. We run the ball up the middle with Najee again. Oh, we play action. Oh, there's Freiermuth over the middle. And then we play defense and cause a few turnovers, and Fields will make a few other big runs. And that just seems what they want to do anyways. And let alone, I just feel like Fields is hungrier. When I see it and watch the game, I just go, the one thing I don't doubt with Justin Fields is he is going to go pedal to the metal red line and do whatever he's got to do to win or make a first down or whatever. And I respect that about him. I do. And I don't think Russell Wilson's a good enough thrower and all that in the pocket right now to just go, oh, he's so much better than Fields in that department that you got to play him. No, he might be better, but it's barely better. And then when you take all the other things into account, I favor Justin Fields as we sit here right now for the Pittsburgh Steelers starting quarterback.
Well, as I watched that game on Saturday night, there's an edge of the seat quality when Fields is in there. There's an entertainment factor.
Right.
The offense seems more exciting than it's been since the days that Ben Roethlisberger still had mobility in his legs.
Right.
So we're talking 5-6 years since you had that. Anything can happen. It could be bad, but anything can happen. There's an anticipation. There's an energy. There's a juice to the offense when Fields is on the field that isn't there when Russell Wilson. Now, to his credit, we showed the highlight earlier. He made a beautiful throw down the sideline to George Pickens, and
yes,
Pickens
did.
Was in. That was a bad call live, and it was a bad call after Mike Tomlin threw the red challenge flag. Pickens had it. He got both feet down. He was in. They blew that one. That was a great throw by Russell Wilson, but that was it. That was the highlight for him for the night. And Fields, on the other hand, even though we saw him moving around, he missed that touchdown.
Yeah, down the middle.
The guy was shot out of a cannon to try to catch it.
Right.
He sprung off of a trampoline, as Homer Simpson would say, and still couldn't get a finger on it. That's how badly Justin Fields missed it.
Well, let's play it again. Re-rack the Justin Fields stuff, guys, if you don't mind. No, but those are things. Here it is. Here's the play. Now these are the things, yeah, you're going to have to live with it with Justin Fields every now and then. He's going to miss this type of throw. He is. Yeah, he needs to throw that soft and across the field and let the guy run that way. But, you know, there was some – these plays right here, Nobody's going to do that in football, really. I mean, Lamar and Mahomes and Josh Allen, and okay, maybe them, but that's it. That's where he's special, so that's where he makes up for, okay, he missed that throw down the middle, I got it, but he made a few other plays where I'd go, Russell Wilson can't do that. Russell Wilson got sacked. Oh, Justin Fields got out and ran for 10. Oh, Russell Wilson got sacked. Oh, Justin Fields got out and got a completion for 4 or 5. So that's where I think he's got just a little more juice in his game and feel and hunger, like I said, let alone I just think he fits Arthur Smith and Mike Tomlin type of football. It's going to be interesting. It sounds like it's going to come all down to this, you know, game three and what they look like there in Pittsburgh, which, you know, get your popcorn ready, Mr. Steelers fan.
If TJ Luther had managed to pull that ball down with that leap that he made at the goal line, that is the highlight of the weekend, all due respect to Patrick Mahomes and the behind-the-back pass. He did everything he could in his power to get that ball, and he still couldn't get a finger on it. And that caused me to be warped. Two plays later was the throw along the sideline. I thought he was throwing it to Quez Watkins. It was like an optical illusion. I just figured he missed him as badly as he missed Luther two plays earlier, and then here's another guy on the sideline that catches it. So it was just kind of a weird play, but it was very effective, and it shows you what Fields can do. And I think even though the competition hasn't been declared yet, and pole position, I guess, I don't know, pole position ends when the race starts, I just feel like, and this goes back to now 51 and a half years of being close enough to Pittsburgh, in and around Pittsburgh, living there, going to college
there. And
you know
you got the pasta and the meatballs. You know the Steelers because of the pasta and the meatballs.
Now, the Steelers from time to time will defy the wishes of the mob, but at the same time, and I mean mob like group of people, not mob mafia, but at the same time, as far as I know, but at the same time, Fields is the guy. Like, Fields is the guy. Oh, sorry, Russ. And this is where that $1.2 million contract is going to hurt him, because they'll have no qualms about making him QB2. You get a 13-year veteran as your backup quarterback who's won a Super Bowl and been to another for $1.2 million. Hell no, we're not cutting him. Hell no, we're not trading him. He's our insurance policy against Justin Fields getting injured.
Yeah.
But it just feels to me like right now, Fields was going against third stringers. I don't care. Fields passes the eyeball test so far, and we didn't see anything out of Russell Wilson that puts him in the Seahawks category as opposed to the Broncos category.
I feel the same way you do, Mike. I do. Just the buzz out of that camp, right? The way it looks on the field. You know, the fact that Russell Wilson, getting over an injury. I mean, I don't know. If they're going to pass protect like we saw the other night, maybe Russell Wilson doesn't want to be a starter the week one anyways. Wait till the Steelers get it figured out a little bit better, protect better, and then maybe when you get your chance then, it'll fit you more. But, you know, as it looks right now, Justin Fields to me brings more to the table, emotionally and physically. Right, I don't trust Russell Wilson's going to throw the ball sometimes, and you know this, and I've talked about this in my quarterback rankings, and you know we've alluded to it and what we think with Sean Payton. He doesn't always see the field that well, and he's reluctant to pull the trigger into tight windows sometimes as a quarterback. Justin Fields, I don't have that worry. It's not perfect. He might miss it every now and then. But for the most part, he tries to be aggressive and take advantage of what's there. It's not perfect like we're talking about, but I think when you couple that, the mindset, his toughness, how he runs, you know, he's stubborn, and I mean that in a good way with how tough he plays. Yeah, I'm feeling Justin Fields too with you, Mike.
The best Russell Wilson moments last year came when everything kind of went haywire and he made things happen, and he kind of needs to take that. And who knows? You never know when Father Time is going to catch you.
Yeah.
Maybe he just can't do it like he did last year. We'll see. But you're right. It's hard at this point to know what Russell Wilson would be in a game that counts, because the pass protection was that bad on Saturday night for both quarterbacks. Here's Mike Tomlin from after the game against the Bills on Russell Wilson's debut.
It's somewhat of an incomplete study because you just don't get a chance to see him operate or us operate. Or us establish rhythm and personality when you're not winning possession downs. And we weren't, you know, the first three or so series of the game, it was, you know, three and out, and that's, you're not gonna get an opportunity to establish rhythm or play the way that you would like as an individual or a collective.
Mike Tomlin had just kind of that quiet, just below the surface, I'm pretty pissed off about what happened tonight with our offensive line. And he made sure that they knew about it before he went out there to meet with the media. The offensive line was not good enough. Nate Herbig, their starting center, is out for an extended stretch with a torn rotator cuff. Zach Frazier, guy who grew up 80 miles from Pittsburgh, 20 miles up the road from me in Fairmont, grew up a Steelers fan, played at West Virginia, fell to pick number 51 because of a torn ACL he suffered against Baylor last November. He steps in now, and he's going to be the anchor of that offensive line, but you got to worry about the edges, like, you know, we saw with Broderick Jones. Every defensive coordinator that faces the Steelers is going to be scheming ways to get great pass rushers on that side to do to Broderick Jones what Greg Rousseau did on Saturday night. So they've got work to do to shore that up and buy time for their quarterbacks. And it's all the more reason to go with Fields if he's going to show a greater mobility and and willingness to use it to get away from that pressure.
Yeah, I think that's it. You know, that would be one of my reasons. You know, you can tie not only his scrambling ability, but his ability to run and the quarterback design run will help the offensive line and help control the pass rush a little bit, because you're always going to have to worry about that. And yet, you know, Russell Wilson does not have that advantage or that skill set to the degree Justin Fields has. So that's where, you know, it'll be interesting. They need, you know, Broderick Jones in their perfect world, too. They wanted him to play left tackle, and the guy they drafted in the first round, and Troy Fontenot, to play right tackle. But that hasn't happened yet either. So they're not a complete. They're not complete as far as what they could potentially be up front. But, yeah, that was rough the other day. And Broderick Jones certainly got schooled a bunch of times by Gregory Rousseau, like you talked about.
There was one other injury that happened Saturday night that I think will affect the thinking as it relates to the quarterback position as well. Jaylen Warren, kind of the unofficial co-starter with Najee Harris. He's got a hamstring injury. He's reportedly going to miss several weeks. You got to be careful with a hamstring. The worse the strain, the longer time you need to get back to 100%. He still has superior burst, acceleration, and explosion to Najee Harris, who's more of a grinded out guy. So if you take the Warren element out of the offense, you almost have greater need for the Fields element, because Fields gives you as a runner
a valid point.
What Warren would have given you, and now that's gone.
Yeah, that's a valid point. Yeah. We know Najee Harris is not an explosive, like, go for 40 yards type of running back. He's more 4, 5, 6, 4, 5. Ooh, should have been tackled behind the line of scrimmage, still got 3 yards. That's what he is. And, yeah, you know, and that, now that makes that more dangerous. You're right. If Justin Fields is in there, to open the field up for him and make him a little more physical, and, of course, Fields gives him that element. I'm with you there, Mike. I'm feeling Justin Fields as we sit here right now, 100%. It feels like he fits the mojo of the Steelers. And if we don't have the fumbles – right in preseason game number one, that kind of left us like a little bad taste in our mouth, the quarterback exchange problems with Justin Fields, I think we're all sitting here today kind of going, what? There's no doubt that Justin Fields should be the starter there in Pittsburgh, right? And as I look at it, I feel it, and I think you're on the same page too.
And ideally, you would like to know who your starter is before the third preseason game, because it goes directly to who else is going to have to play in that game, who else is going to be exposed to injury. If we're doing a full-blown quarterback competition, you want to give both guys chances with the starting offense. They have to be out there longer than maybe you wanted. So I'd say that most coaches like to know before that last preseason game, even though there's only three now, who the guy is going to be.
Okay, you have a chance to win $1 million in the NBC sweepstakes on Yahoo Fantasy. Just download the redesigned Yahoo Fantasy app or go to NBCSports.com/FantasyMillion for additional details. What are you waiting for?
Hi, it's Mike Florio. Thanks for watching PFT on YouTube. Hit subscribe for the latest news and analysis from Pro Football Talk.